watching Southland TV. I'm Melissa Fedora. We're here today in beautiful downtown Tinley Park at Cuzin's on Oak Park Avenue. We're going to be launching a new show today. We're going to be going inside, doing some hands-on work, meeting the owners. We'll be in the kitchen. We'll be behind the bar. It's going to be a lot of action. So stick around, join us. And if you ever want to watch any of our other previous shows, you can visit our website at www.southlandtv.us. We're going to go inside. And we are now inside of Cuzin's in Tinley Park on Oak Park Avenue in the beautiful downtown Tinley area. And I'm joined here with the owner, Dennis Suglich. Thank you so much for showing us around and letting us spend some time inside your beautiful place here. And I look forward to asking you a lot of questions today.
Thank you. Thank you for being here.
Wonderful. Dennis, let's start off. I want you to kind of give me a little bit of background information. How long have you and your lovely wife, Karen, how long have you owned the place, and what made you decide that you wanted to own the place?
Well, you know, we've had Cuzin's in Tinley Park now for about 15 years.
Okay.
And when I grew up in the city of Chicago, I grew up in the hospitality business. So I grew up in the bars, in the bowling alleys, in the pizza business. And when we relocated out here in the southwest suburbs, I decided that, heck, why not have my own place? And that was really the driving factor for first establishing Cuzin's.
Okay. So when you established Cuzin's, were you the one that came up with the name?
It was kind of a group effort. So when we first opened up Cuzin's, it was myself and my cousin. And we knew that pretty quick that the name was Cuzin's, but the spelling was kind of, how do we get a hook on the name and, you know, what makes us unique from just the normal Cuzin's? Well, at the time, my wife was a teacher at St. George School, and so we are throwing out different ideas of the spelling, and I came up with Cuzins, and I was scolded that was the improper spelling of the word Cuzin's. Right then and there, we knew that was right. So
there's a little rebellion with this name.
A little bit.
So this is not your only location. You have this Tinley Park, and then you also have Midlothian. Tell me a little bit about Midlothian and, from what I hear, the beautiful patio.
Yes. So we did open up Midlothian about 18 months ago, and we wanted to dive into what would it be like to have more than one Cuzin's. So it was, right? A lot of people said second Cuzin's, kissing Cuzin's, you know, all of the Cuzin's jokes. So we did open up a second location, and we attempted our growth within Midlothian.
Okay. And tell me a little bit about the patio then. You have, it's outside, you have bean bags, landscaping, bar. Tell me a little bit about the logistics of it.
Yes, so we did do an outside bar. It was very important to have an outside dining area and attraction. The inside of Cuzin's Midlothian is significantly smaller than our Tinley Park inside. So, but we also wanted to accommodate for everyone there in the nicer weather. And so we did do an outside bar. We made it really nice. We made an outside pavilion area that has an outside bar with, you know, we really went top shelf, granite countertops.
Wow.
We put in outside TVs. We have HD TVs to watch all your sporting events.
Okay.
We close the outside patio in the wintertime, so and keep it heated. So helps with the climate a little bit in the colder weather here. We have an outside beanbag court. I designed it to be bocce ball, and I found out that not a whole heck of a lot of people really knew what bocce ball was, so it went into a beanbag court, and a lot of tables and chairs and umbrellas. We put in some really nice landscaping, so it's really like being in someone's backyard with a little added bar and a few TVs out there, so it's nice.
Okay. Do you do any live music there? I know live music is very big here, and we'll get into that next, but do you do any live music there?
Yes, we do live music. During the nicer weather, we do music on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday there as well. But because it's a smaller inside, the music's generally outside, and during the winter, it really can't accommodate a lot of music inside with the bands. So on Sundays, we still have some acoustic acts with open mics on Sunday afternoons in Midlothian, but until the weather gets a little nicer, we'll pick up Friday and Saturday bands out in the patio.
Okay, so tell us a little bit about your music then here, because you are pretty well known for this area of the Chicago Southland to have blues jams, open mics, live bands. So kind of give me what we can expect here in Tinley Park.
Yeah, so music is really big to me. I love music. I think it really brings a lot of people together. It's fun. And we do music Friday night and Saturday night every week here in Tinley Park at 9 p.m. Never a cover charge. We never charge anybody to come in. So everything, the genres change, go from rock and roll, country music, blues. We cover the whole spectrum, 60s, 70s, rockabilly, you name it, we play it. Sundays, we really are known in the blues industry to have one of the best blues jams in the city within Chicagoland and open mic. So on Sundays, you can expect at 4 o'clock every Sunday, anywhere from a dozen to 30 different musicians showing up and playing their instruments. We do have a house band, the Billy King Band, that starts everything off, and he organizes it. Billy's one of the best blues guitarists in Chicago, and his band starts everything off. And you have guys that'll come in if they want to play the drums. They can use the drum kit that's here. They can plug their guitars into the existing amp. They want to get up and just sing a song. The rest of the band members will stay up here. So whether you play trombone, keyboards, drums, bass guitar, electric guitar, you name it, come on up, harmonica, and come on out and join the blues.
Wow, that is very neat. Definitely something you don't really see a lot of around here. So very cool. So you also not only are known for wonderful music, but for a really nice menu. So tell us a little bit about your menu, and then I also want you to tell us about your delicious pizzas.
Well, sure. You know, like I said earlier, you know, I grew up in the bar business, and one of the things that I remember being in the bar business, in the neighborhood bar, is that they always had food that was cooked from scratch, and it wasn't just throw it in the fryer or take it out of a bag. So the food's important to me. Sometimes we say it's, you know, bar food with a twist.
And the twist is it's delicious.
Well, the twist is that it's delicious, but it's also is that we make it from scratch and prepare it fresh as best as possible. So you'll see signs throughout our Cuzins that, you know, food's prepared to order. It may take a little longer.
Worth the wait.
It is. I like to think it's worth the wait. As you can tell, I like to eat, and so it's going to be good food. I'm not just going to throw junk out there. So we make it from scratch as much as possible. It's made fresh, and you know, we use the best ingredients, and that's really important, that all the ingredients that we use are fresh. Our burgers are never frozen. It's fresh Black Angus burgers, half pound, and they never hit a freezer. From down in the stockyards, we get our burgers brought in. They're custom made for Cuzins. We bring them in, or whether it's our pot roast sandwich, so we call it Yes Mom's Yesterday's Pot Roast, and you know, it's always better the second day, so you know, and so that's a slow cooked 12-14 hour smoked pot roast. Whether it's the ingredients on our pizza that are cut and sliced fresh, you know, everything is as best. We're not a Ruth Chris downtown or a Gibson Steakhouse, but you know, maybe we're half a step underneath them, and we care about it.
Well, without having a ranch out back, I think you're doing the best you absolutely can. That sounds delicious. So do you have any plans to expand the brand in the future?
You know, I think that Midlothian was really our entree into growth in the southwest suburbs. Like I said, we opened it about 18 months ago. So, you know, managing multiple locations is somewhat a different animal than managing a single location. You really have to depend on staff a lot more and leverage the expertise that other people have. So we're learning a lot right now, but it really would be nice, and it's always at the forefront of what I'm thinking about is where's our third location going to be. So I think here sometime soon, you might see 3, 4, and 5, you know. So we're trying. We have really good people, and that's how we'll grow this business, is with our staff.
So So, besides your great food and your live music, what are some other things that you do? Are there special things for football or special things for holidays? And I know you've got to have something special for the big Tinley Park St. Patrick's Day parade that goes right past here.
Yeah, so we try to do, you know, being a neighborhood bar and really being our own community within the community, we try to do as many events and special things to recognize our customers, you know, kind of give back to them a little bit. For example, for the Bears games, we always have a halftime spread of free food for halftime. And it's not just, again, it's not just throwing out some pizzas and, you know, maybe some chips and chicken wings and saying, here you go, you know, this is what we do every week. Every week we really have a theme menu and try to make it nice for the people that come in and enjoy the Bears game here. We traditionally have every year a Cub Sox outing, so we get a couple motor coaches and we load up the buses and we go down to US Cellular and barbecue in the parking lot. We do some tailgating. We have parties. A New Year's Eve party, so we always have a New Year's Eve party. And one of the things that we try to as best as possible is really make it available for all the customers. So whether the upcoming Super Bowl here in February, we're not going to necessarily charge you $50, $75 to come in and watch the game. You want to come in and have one beer, you want to have a Coke, you want to, you know, whatever. You want to come in with your friends and watch the game, come on in. You know, it's just like the bands. We don't charge a cover charge. Come in. We're a neighborhood joint. We want everyone to be welcome. So we try to do as many activities as possible. The Irish Parade, that's something that we do. It's as everyone knows, in the Tinley Park area, it's one of the biggest bar days of the year. Last year, we set up a big tent outside, and we had tents in the parking lot. We're planning on doing the same thing this year. We have live music during that event. We always have traditionally put in a float in a parade.
I was going to ask you that. You usually have a float, right? And so who's on that float? Is it bartenders, you, customers? Who's in the float?
Well, really, it's really pretty unique because our customers all get together to make the float. And we don't have it professionally done. I donate the beer and the pizza while they're making it. And they all get together in one of local customers' garages, and they build it. And they do a phenomenal job. And the last three times we've had a float, we won first place.
Wow.
So it's something that I really can take very little credit for other than the name Cuzins. The customers really put everything into it. And we have engineers, we have carpenters, we have pipe fitters, we have sprinkler fitters, we have, you know, all the trades that help get involved, and it really speaks to who we are. We're that blue collar, feel at home, everyone gets to works together, everyone gets along type of place.
What a neat way for your customers to be able to kind of show off their talent and their skills and to be able to do that for you, and you shouldn't sell yourself short. I think you do contribute a lot with the pizza and the beer. So, you are, from what I hear, talking about refreshing the menu a little bit and maybe doing some new things. So tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, so that's true. You know, again, you know, because we do have the same clientele a lot, it's really the regular type of place. We have a lot of people that aren't regulars that come in. But one of the things that I want is that to make it interesting as much as possible, the menu within our means of being a bar. So we are really looking at every 6 to 12 months, somewhere in between, we like to refresh our menu. We take some things off, we add some new things, we try to be creative. I have a lot of friends and associates that are in the culinary industry, and we talk a lot about different things. So we are coming up with some new things for the menu here, and hopefully we'll be out in the next 30, 60 days. Give you a little sneak peek into...
That was my next question. We want a little sneak peek. We want to know what to try.
Well, all I could tell you is probably there's some really cool things that are going into the menu. One that probably most people are not familiar with or haven't heard about that I'm really excited about are PB&J wings.
Okay.
Yes.
That sounds interesting. What are some of the things on your menu that you suggest that people should try? Where, you know, everybody already knows the pizza is a good safe bet. It's going to be great. But if you want to try something different, what would you say? Step outside, think outside the box, and try this because it's a slam dunk.
Well, obviously outside the pizza, our top-selling item other than pizza is our burgers. Like I mentioned before, we use a fresh black Angus meat made for us in the stockyards. It's brought here fresh. So our burgers are really good. We bring in fresh pretzel rolls and brioche buns that they're prepared on. But kind of outside of the normal thing is on the menu, you will see yesterday's pot roast sandwich. So it really is a phenomenal sandwich, and it's a slow cooked pot roast that's almost like biting into a filet mignon. So, and it has a nice sauce on it. It's a nice bun. Definitely will fill you up. So, and then the other thing that maybe is kind of outside the realm of what you'd get on an everyday, or you know, well, you may get them every day. It's like our wraps, our chicken wraps, you know. Our wings, one thing about our wings that I think are very important to announce is that they're not just breaded and deep fried. So our wings are rubbed with a special recipe rub, and they're baked. And so we bake our wings, and then when they're ordered up, we only flash fry them to heat them up. They're fully cooked in the oven, so they're not just drenched in grease. They are naked, so they don't have breading, and then we have multiple sauces. So our wings are a little bit, again, with a twist. It's a little than the norm that you might get at other places. They take a wing and throw them in a fryer, and they cook and drown them in sauce. I really have some background flavor to them.
Okay. And do you have specials on any certain day of the week?
We do. We have specials every day, Monday through Friday and Saturday. We have drink specials 7 days a week. Some of our food specials, our longer-lasting food specials that have been there, we try to change those up too, but those longer lasting ones are like $4 burgers on Tuesday. The biggest one is our half price pizza on Monday. So people love our half price pizza on Monday. Come on in, enjoy a half price pizza. Again, just, you know, giving back a little bit on to our customers and mixing it up a little bit.
So if anybody's not sure about the pizza and they want to try it, it's only half off on Monday, so that'd be the day to do it. So one last thing I want to ask you. I noticed just sitting here, and I've been here before, but I noticed just sitting here that this place sort of has the Cheers feel. Everybody's just mingling and talking with each other, and everybody seems like they know each other. And of course, your bartender that's here tonight is, I know, been here for a very long time, and I imagine probably a lot of your staff has. So is that a goal of yours, is to feel like everybody knows your name, that hometown feel? And how do you achieve that?
Well, I really think it starts with me and my wife, with the ownership, right? And it's, we appreciate everyone's business, and I love people. So, I mean, that I think is key, and then that conveys into our staff and to our customers, where everyone does feel welcome. So even if you're a stranger and you walk in and there's six guys that are here every day, they're going to welcome you. You're going to feel welcome getting part of that conversation. And really is that, you know, we are a bar. We're going to get some undesirable people that come in once in a while. The key is that I don't accept that. So if you're not going to get along and you're not going to be friendly in your nature at the bar, you know, we have been known to refuse service, and I will ask people to leave, and that is the instructions of all of our staff, is we're here to have a good time, have fun, enjoy yourself. Doesn't mean you have to be part of the conversation. You want to sit in the corner and unwind and mind your own thing, or get on the internet and work on your computer, whatever, that's fine. But everyone's going to get along, and we're going to have a good time.
Well, that's very nice, and we certainly appreciate sitting down phone and being able to have conversation with you one-on-one. And we're going to take a little look around here and do some fun things here as well. So thanks for sitting down and answering my many questions that I had. Thanks, Dennis.
Great. Thank you.
So now we're behind the bar at Cuzin's in downtown Tinley Park, and Dennis is going to introduce us to one of his staff members here, and she's going to make a drink for us. Dennis, who are we meeting?
This is Baby. Baby's been with us for 6 years, and she's going to make a really healthy drink for us right now.
Oh, healthy, electrolytes and all that good stuff. All right, Baby, so what do you have for us?
I have a green tea shot, and it's super simple to make.
Okay.
So you just use Jameson, you use peach schnapps, and you use sour mix.
Okay. I think even a novice can do this, right? So three ingredients.
Yeah.
Okay. So what do you put in first?
It doesn't really matter. You can put Jameson in, then peach schnapps, and then sour, because sour is not as much. You don't want a lot of sour, because you know.
And we're going to put all this in a shaker, shake it
until it's frosted, and then you pour it in the glass.
So about how much Jameson to the other two? Is it more Jameson?
Even Jameson with the peach schnapps, and then a little sour, because too much sour is just nasty.
Okay, this sounds good. And we don't even need a garnish. We're just going to shoot this?
Just shoot it.
I like it. Excellent. All right, let's do it. So we're still behind the bar, and we're still with the owner, Dennis. And Dennis, you are going to slowly walk us through, step by step, a very complicated shot, but it's really worth it. So we're going to go slowly, and Mark, our photog here, is going to get in some tight angles, some wide angles, so we can go through this step by step. And if you can't follow along, we will have the recipe on our website, southlandtv.us. So, okay, we're going to start. Let's do step one of about 10. So step one, here we go.
Well, I think it's real important to explain what tools are used for this, because it's not the normal cocktail. So you have to have, you know, really the bartender's basics. We need a shaker. It has to have a strainer on the top. You need another strainer.
Yes.
All right. You need a muddler. And one thing, expectation that people need to understand is that this will take a while to make. So you can't come in and like rush the bartenders and say, yo, where's my drink? You know, Dennis showed me this.
Right.
You
know, but it's worth the wait.
Right. So once you have all of these things, one of the important things is you got to fill the shaker up with ice. All right. And so once you have that filled with ice, you have all of this stuff in here, you have to have your shot glasses. Don't worry about this anymore. Okay. All you really need to do is get a bottle of Crown Apple. All right.
Okay.
You get the Crown Apple. You pour it in.
Magic happens.
Pour it in each of these shot glasses.
Okay.
The secret is this has to be in a 37 degree cooler.
Got it.
Once you have that, that's it. We have our top secret drink. Cheers.
Cheers. Hope you're able to follow along with that.
I need like 12 cigarettes.
So we're inside Cuzin's talking to some regular patrons. We have Frank and Rick, if that is their real names. And can you tell me a little bit about why you choose, of all the places in the area that you can go to, why do you choose Cuzin's right here in Tinley Park?
Well, it's a funny thing you asked that, because this is where all my friends hang out. We have a good time here. They got good bands, great music. You know, it's a wonderful place to be. You know, and look around. I know everybody in here, and I think they know me.
Maybe it looks like it. It looks like it. So I think, would you be Norm, or would you be, who is the mailman?
I'm not the mailman. I don't like to walk.
Okay, you're Norm. Got it. So Rick over here. Rick, why are you a regular? I'm going to go out on a limb and say you're a regular. Why are you a regular here?
I'm going to say a little bit of what Frank just said. I like all my friends are here. Good food, great bands. And of course, Baby and Tina work here. That's why I'm here.
Obviously. And I assume you like the owners as well. They must be real nice people.
Oh, very good people. Very good people. The friends and the owners, everything's good. Food's great. Bands are great. Miss Why I'm Here all the time. A great neighborhood bar.
He's working off that bar tab, I think. Well, thank you. Thank you so much for talking to us. And
thanks for asking these great questions.
How could you not like being here, of course? The ambiance is great.
And you're here, too, which isn't a bad thing.
Today.
Mm-hmm. Well, come back soon.
I will.
All righty.
Back again.
We are here in the kitchen of Cuzin's, and I'm here with the chef.
Hi, my name's Tom. This is Dennis, and we're just hanging out making some pizzas and showing you what we do here.
So these guys have no idea what a horrible, hopeless cook I am, but they say that they're going to be able to teach me how to cook a wonderful, delicious pizza for their guests. But we're not going to let them actually eat it, so don't worry. All right, so here's step one. We are putting it through a flattener thing.
A flattener thing. That's the dough roller.
The dough roller.
We have a flattener thing, but we got a little more better at that, you know. Now we got a dough roller.
Okay.
All right.
And how many times are we putting it through that?
Oh, that's a secret. We can't let in on that.
Okay.
No, it really is.
Okay. We won't tell you.
We have this finished process here.
Okay.
And then we come over here to our ingredient line. Dennis, you want to take over on this?
How do we get all the holes in this? Or is that a secret too?
Yeah, you know what? Something really cute.
We can tell. There's really not too much secret. Would you like to try to push it through the dough roller one time?
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Let's go back to step one. We're going to go through the dough roller. We're going to flip on this switch.
Every time you do it, you got to go a little less.
Okay. And I'm going to just slide it like this. Oh, beautiful. Okay, now I want to use this medieval contraption here.
Sure.
So. This is to keep the air bubbles from popping up, correct?
You're correct, and that's called a docker.
All right, so here we go. We're going to docker it up. Ooh, we're going to I'm trying to do one-handed here. Okay, we're going to docker it up. Oops. This is why they're the professionals. See, it's not as easy as you think. All right, so now we're not going to have those big earthy bubble things that pop up in the bottom. We're going to have this beautiful flat pizza, right? Okay, now.
Ta-da! All right, so now we have Tommy, our longtime chef. He's going to prep one of our thin crust pizzas for us. So the first thing that he puts on the dough is he puts our homemade sauce. So this is a homemade sauce that we make on a regular basis. It has fresh ingredients, fresh herbs, fresh spices. Everything's in there, fresh tomatoes. So once he has the sauce done, what we're going to do is we're going to make this a sausage mushroom green pepper pizza. And this is a special blend of sausage that we have made just for Cuzin's. It's a traditional sausage. It's a sweet sausage. You'll notice when you've tasted it that you'll taste the sweet fennel in there. It's one of the things that are really known with Chicago pizzas. So Tommy's going to put this sausage on the pizza. We put some really healthy portions on there, and you won't get that at a lot of other pizza places. It's not just a cheap old crumbled sausage or the ground beef. It's really some nice traditional sausage from Chicago.
So let me ask you while we're doing this, where do you get the sausage from, or is that a secret?
Well, it's a blend, and it's really kind of one of our secrets that we have, but it is made here in the Chicagoland area for us based off of a recipe and a spec that we give the purveyor.
Okay, so it's local, so we like it. All right, back to step number two, I think we're at.
Two or three, somewhere in the pizza process. But one of the things that you notice when Tom's putting the mushrooms on, they're not out of a can. And if you've ever had a canned mushroom, you know the flavor. It's not necessarily a bad thing, but it's not something that I prefer. That's one of the things that separate our pizzas from other places' pizzas, that they're top ingredients. It's all fresh. We slice those mushrooms in-house. And you'll see the next ingredient that he puts on are our green peppers. Again, they're sliced in-house. Are fresh green peppers that we have brought in all the time, and we slice them up, and sometimes you might get them a little thicker than other times. It's just what the chef makes them, so we try to keep them consistent, but when you use fresh ingredients, it varies a little bit. It's more of an art than a science.
Of course, and that's what's wonderful about it, is that it's not being cut through a machine where it's going to be exactly the same every single time. It's exactly like you said, it's an art, so everybody's going to do it just slightly different, and that's okay. Different hands brands make different pizzas, which is absolutely fine. But when it's all fresh, it's all good.
So let me can I tell you about the cheese? One of the probably the most important thing of a pizza is the cheese. So believe it or not, that's the most expensive ingredient going on the pizza. And why is that? Because we have a fresh cheese that comes out of California. We have two different blends of cheese. We grind it in-house. We have it brought to us in blocks. We grind that down, and it goes on our pizza nice and fresh. And you'll see it when it melts. It melts an even melt, and it's not some imitation mozzarella cheese.
So you're shredding your own cheese right here. So it's it as fresh as it can get. You've got the block. You're shredding it. You're cutting all your ingredients. I swear the best part of a pizza is when the green pepper is fresh. I don't even want a green pepper on my pizza if it's coming out of a can. It's got that slimy. It's not crunchy. This looks delicious. So I think our next step is the oven?
Yes, the next step is to put it into our oven.
We're making a delicious hamburger with the chef, and we're going to be making pot roast too. So what have we done so far?
Well, we got our half pound burger over here, and we start out seasoning on both sides, put it on the open flame here and let it start cooking. And at that time, we're going to start out with our pot roast over here. If you give me a second.
Okay.
And we'll let that sizzle a little bit.
Ooh, it's sizzling.
And while that's cooking, we're going to get our bread going. And we want to toast both sides of the bread, and we want to toast both sides of the burger bread also.
Okay.
We got a little secret sauce in there, but I can't show you what that is.
Ooh, it's a secret. And Dennis, why are these so delicious? What is your secret as to why this meat is so good and why this pot roast is so good?
Well, as we said earlier, the burgers are our top never frozen Black Angus beef. And the pot roast is a slow-cooked premium pot roast, and we finish it off here on the grill, so when we bring it out to the customer, it's nice and hot, has a nice little crisp to it.
Perfect.
Okay, now that the pot roast is nice and warmed up here, we top it up with a cheddar cheese, then we pile it high with some freshly made onion rings. We'll give that a few minutes to melt. We'll put a lid on it and let it melt nice and beautiful. We'll flip our burger while that's going. Burgers medium rare, we're good with that to go. We'll plate that off here, and you have your choice of what you would like to call on it, your cheese, bacon, mushrooms. We have many, many ingredients.
So we're going to dress it up with all these beautiful, well, delicious ingredients.
It's totally what the customer would want on there.
And all homemade, correct?
All homemade, all made right here.
Excellent. The coleslaw looks delicious, homemade. So many different choices here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's like 10 different things here that you can get on your burger.
About 17.
Oh, 17. Wow, right. Delicious.
We give them a nice healthy order of fries with it.
Okay.
It gets an order of coleslaw with that also.
Okay. Order of coleslaw. And the coleslaw is homemade?
Everything is homemade. Yes, the answer is yes.
Excellent.
And this is what you would get.
Ooh, delicious. Look at that masterpiece. So Dennis and Karen, the owners here at Cuzin's, they're very into trying to establish the brand, and I think they've done a fantastic job so far with all the years that they've owned Cuzin's, and they've participated in a lot of community events, and they've really established themselves as a local community bar. So what are some things that you would like to continue to do, and what are some successes that you think you've done with establishing your Cuzin's brand?
Well, I think that it's real important that we are known for what we are and not try to pretend to be something that we're not. So what we are is we're a neighborhood bar. That's truly who we are. We're about the neighborhood. We're about the people in the neighborhood. We're not trying to be anything too fancy. Really, our model really kind of sums it up for us in terms of food you won't forget, drinks you can't remember. So, I mean, it's about having a good time, about a friendly place, and being a neighborhood bar. That's really the roots of who we are, and that's who we want to be at the core.
What was that slogan one more time? Because I think it's great. It needs to be on some t-shirts. If it's not, all already.
Food you won't forget, drinks you can't remember.
I love it. We're going to go behind the bar next with Tina. Come join us. So we're behind the bar, and Dennis is going to introduce us to another one of his longtime employees.
Hi, yes, this is Tina. Tina's been with us for a little over 12 years now, one of our most experienced bartenders.
Definitely. Tina, I want to ask you a couple questions. I want to ask you, number one, what makes you love working here? Because you don't generally work someplace for 12 years if you're miserable, right?
Right. I just really love the people. I love the people. I love my bosses. I just love this place.
And I know a big goal here is to make sure that it feels like the neighborhood bar, the local bar, that everybody knows each other and everybody's comfortable here. And I know the bartender is like the captain behind the ship steering that. So what do you do to make sure that everybody feels comfortable and like everyone knows who they are?
I just make them feel at home, give them that at-home atmosphere.
Do you feel like you know a lot about everybody and maybe sometimes you feel like you're a little bit part shrink, part friend?
You know, we are like a family here. I mean, they are friends. We all do things together outside the bar. They are. They're friends. They're family. They really are.
I think that is the key. And I think behind every successful establishment, it could be a bar, it could be a restaurant, it could be the corner bakery store. I think the biggest thing is when you have a familiar face that when you walk in, you know you're going to see the same person every time, and you really are that to this establishment. And I'm sure the owners and the customers alike are so happy to have you here, and it's a little bit of consistency in their lives, and they know you're always going to be here for them. So I'm sure I can speak on behalf of the owners and the staff. Thank you for being here and for being kind of the happy place for everybody here.
You're welcome. Thank you. Thank you.
So that's a wrap here from beautiful downtown Tinley Park at Cuzin's on Oak Park Avenue. We spent some time in the kitchen. We spent some time behind the bar. We learned about drink specials. We learned how to make some new drinks. And we had a real nice chat with the owner. So, if you'd like to watch this program again, visit us at www.southlandtv.us.